Looks like another complaint. Kirk's always, oh my gosh, his YouTube always complaining. Look at this. So went to Bank of America right here. Yeah, because that's where I deposited a check they made for construction on Sunday. Okay. Now they've changed the rules, the laws, the B system, that they hold on to your money for over a 24-hour business day to make sure the funds clear. Like the bank has anybody who has to worry about stealing from us when they're stealing from, I mean, they're stealing from us. We have to worry about them. They worry about us stealing from them. You kidding me? I mean, this is a new law that came along, and not a law, but a new rule. Well, they basically are the law, the banking financial system. That is your one world government, folks. The money, they worship, everybody worships the money. Your government, the one world government, has already been positioned. It's been here for a long time. Wake up. So anyway, so here it is. So, and it gets worse. At 4 o'clock, they close the doors at Bank of America at 4 o'clock. Are you kidding me? Who gets off at 4 o'clock? There's a ton of people going up and going, I got to go in. And they turn around in shock and disappointment. I can't get my money. Are you kidding me? Now, yes, you can choose other banks, but all the other banks have the same rules about the 24 hours. I mean, Kirk James might steal from the bank. So, so we got to hold his money. You know what actually happens? They sit on your money and they gain interest. It actually float money. It's called, I thought it's kayaking, but it might be kiting versus kiting. Yes, kiting. They get a kayak on your money for as long as they can hold it. So then guess what else? So TD Ameritrade, I'm trying to actually short the market because I'm going the opposite direction. They're going to try to destroy the middle class. They already have. But they're blowing that thing right off the roof and they're going to drop it out on everybody to try to get their one world currency thing going. But anyway, so here's the deal. So I had transferred to TD Ameritrade, not a lot of money because I don't have a lot of money. We're talking like, you know, $400, right? Because I want to put a little trade on. And they've been sitting on my money for 5 days now. It's supposed to be an overnight transaction. And they pulled this game on me about a couple months ago. I put some money in there and they sat on it for, oh, it was like 2 weeks. 2 weeks using my money and I got nothing in return, nothing. The guy said, well, I don't know where your funds are. They're just kind of just floating around somewhere. You guys use my money. And here's the thing is, are you kidding me? And I'm doing the same thing at TD Ameritrade. I didn't try to call them. Guess what the wait is? 20 minutes. I said, I don't have time. I'm on construction. So I got time for this. I mean, and here's what really upsets me. Oh, there's a little bird stretching its wings. Oh, it's so cute. Yeah, little bird. Just a baby. I got distracted again. How are you doing there, bud? Anyway, so here's the thing is, you know, we talk about, that we've progressed. No, we haven't. We've regressed. I mean, we have regressed so deep into this hole that it is sick. This system is sick. They said, we got computers and we've automated everything. Oh my gosh, it is 10 times. It's a nightmare. You can't get anything done. And I've been waiting for some correction because somebody mistyped my social security card number in the food bank system because desperate for food funds that I've been waiting for 6 months for food to come from a Colorado program. And these ladies are working there. God bless their hearts. They've been trying their hardest to fix the system. And, it's like, oh, I mean, are you kidding me? I mean, really? And, you know, and I was in the software field and, you know, we'd have people, I was working for Kaiser. Some people couldn't get a surgery for their child because somebody had did something stupid in the database or, instead. So they used to tell me, oh, don't worry about that to one person, Kirk, or that 5 or 10 that are hung up. And I'm like, if that was your child, wouldn't you want it fixed immediately? You know, because we could go in and fix it immediately. And they said, well, no, we'll wait till next week or, you know, we'll get it in the next wrap up, right? Should be fixed immediately or work outside the computer system. See, it's a push button society. You know, they should just approve it on the sideline. Here, sign a piece of paper, go get your child, get their surgery done, you know, or whatever needs to be done, you know, or get your health take care, get your medication. We'll take care of the paperwork later, right? It's always no, 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 no. We need yes, 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 right? And here's the thing is about it. What a trickery. Now, yes, I agree that computers have helped our society. They have. I wouldn't be talking cell phone right now, you know, broadcasting this. You know what I mean? Right now, this is because of the technology. Technology, see, science and spirituality can get along. That's where everyone wants to divide. It's division again. Don't want science to commingle and be a part of this, right? So it's the fence again, the division. So I'm hoping in the new earth, I don't know the details. I hope that we can bridge all these gaps, technology with science and, you know, technology and science with spirituality, okay? You know, because, so anyway, here's my thing. Also that back in the 70s and 80s, they said, boy, there's going to be no need for paper. They said computers are just going to take care of everything, and it's just going to just get rid of all paper, and there'll be no more cutting the forests and trees. Guess what, folks? We use more paper today than any newspapers ever produced in history. That even a guy I used to work for, his name was Chuck Hill. He used to work for IBM and also used to work for a paper company before IBM, before he became a software engineer. And he said he was sitting in a meeting back in the, I think the 70s. He said, you should have seen him laugh. He said, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do with this paper company? It was one of the major ones that came here, Hammer Mill or whatever. And he said, they said they're all worried about it. He said, everybody's gonna lose their jobs. The manager's like, man, we're gonna need a paper, these computers come along. Guess what? He's the only one that stood up and said, folks, you're gonna see paper usage, because he was a realist. He could read through the bull crap, the system like you and I can. He could see truths. And he said bull crap to them. He goes, you're going to see more paper use ever. He said, man, next 5-10 years, boy, he said they were ripping paper like you can believe. They're out of their minds of how they couldn't, the demand of paper and tearing down forests just to try to keep up with the demand. Okay. So what my point is this, that there again, we don't really have that balance. We know we're tearing up our forests and we're printing more paper off today. It's in, and look around our recycling. Look at this. These people just trash our earth like whatsoever. There's just no care. I even see a soda bottle, a soda can over there that's not even been used. Somebody just probably tossed it. It could have dropped out. Somebody get that, somebody that. But you'll see that all the time. You know, I see people, you know, open up a pop can, take in 3 drinks, and just, and it's not because they just don't like, I just had enough and set aside. There's people starving this world, right? You're kidding me. I found, you know, water bottles, and there's something like this. They just need basic water. And I'll see people like, you know, even this construction sites, they'll drink like 4 things of water and just say, you know, I don't set aside. And the water has no value to them. They'll just like, well, I can just go buy another bottle of water. You know what I mean? I'm always hunting my water down because I don't have the funds for it. Or asking, you know, if I can borrow some water because sometimes they run out. I mean, so talk about just being an overly blessed, overly pigs. Pigs, folks. So sorry, that's my rant. Always got to have a rant for the day. But anyway, don't worry about it. It'll be fixed in the end. We know this. The loose strings will be tied up, and you know, your God, your Creator, He's gonna help us fix this garbage. And I'm telling you. And then you got your little liquor bottle down there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. An over-consuming society. You know what I mean? And that's the thing is, like I told you many times, if they really care about this mask crap, right? If they really cared, why aren't we taking care of some of these things right here? Like, you know, people are starving on the streets, people starving in other countries. Like you said, the numbers are 25,000 a day die from starvation. And guess what the vaccine is? The vaccine is food. You got it right there. That's the cure. But you think these politicians care? Nah. Nope. No, they don't care. You know, one guy who told me one time, he had a great, this great gentleman, and he said the greatest words that I'd heard. I said, what do you think about voting for these presidents? He said, I didn't vote. And I'm not judging by his race, he's a black guy. I said, oh, you didn't vote? He goes, oh, no. You know, mine says vote for God. But anyway, you know, back in my vehicle. But here's what he said. He said, I'm going to vote for the first president that's actually walked the streets of New York City, or just even here in Phoenix, that have seen and witnessed and heard what is going on and just has a heart. Just walked the streets. Just been there and actually helped somebody or just looked. He said, I've never seen a president walk, I mean, candidate ever walk the streets in the dark, in the night, or in the daytime and see the homeless and actually experience that? Heck no. So are they working for the people of all races, religion, and color? Are they only working for the elite, the ones they think the vote only counts? I agree with the man. I don't care if it's a lady. The first one that walks the streets and has a heart and sees what's going on. You know, the ones that know that we're not talking about deep state. We're talking about deep spirituality, deep love. The one that's been the deep in the trenches. The one that's been the front line of this country. Not the top line, not the upper crust. The ones that show true beyond just the working man and lady. The ones that have tried and worked as hard as they can and still been beaten by the system because of some situation. Yes, some have caused it themselves. I'm not going to disagree with that. But what about the true ones? We got veterans on these streets. You know, that you know, their wife died and they lost everything. We got veterans that could not get funds from the government by timing. Timing is key. Like me being hauled up the banks. They lost their home or their rent or the apartment because they couldn't get the funds from the government they were promised. There's stories like that all the time. There are people right now that still haven't got their first paycheck from the IRS on the stimulus package. My mother's one of them. She gets every excuse in the book. We don't know why you're not getting it. There's Angel Lamont. She goes, I don't know why. They said there's some kind of weird transaction happened between her and the bank, her bank. And try calling them. You'll sit on the phone for, see, it took me 80 hours just to get one paycheck from them. 80 hours. That continuous, I monitored my phone. I recorded it, how long it took me. 80 hours, folks. Think how much work I could have done on these, you know, helping somebody or just working for raising money for funds myself. So who serves who? See, we formed a government to serve us. Now we serve them. It's completely upside down. It is all upside down. This world's all upside down. All right? God bless you and love you all. Okay? We got to change this. This is not the way it's supposed to be. Love you.